starting to think that this is about as close to fall colors as I will ever get here in Paris. And as I contemplate this reality, I wonder when the damn trees are gonna turn anyway. Eh? You step in off the riverfront into the great garden. It is it is truly lovely here. Yeah. Up there in that great open space is the entrance to the Louvre. And then the far extending galleries to the end. That's actually another museum in that wing. A museum of decorative arts and publicity. But it's still part of the Louvre Palace. And then you begin this great park, which has been a park for about 500 years, the Tuileries. And here, I am just going to sit down for a while and take a break. Look, brown leaves.
Hello.
That is the man who tried the same ruse on me, picking something up off the ground. And asking me if it was mine. Look at that. The attic has four rows of round windows. And all those chimneys, damn. All those chimneys. It's extraordinary. And the material wealth that can pile up at the center of a great empire. And even more so, the cultural wealth that accumulates until it creates huge edifices to show itself off. Now those are buildings of the city, alongside the Rue de Rivoli, which is the northern boundary of the Tuileries Park. And they run for block after block after block into the west. Now, we are quickly approaching sunset. When this park, well, the park closes by the clock, not by the sunset. But this is a very golden hour. And plenty of people taking advantage of the lovely weather to walk and enjoy this ancient park. I lost him. Well, he looked like he was having fun. The park is not only home for antique sculpture, but oh, passez-vous, s'il vous plaît. Also home for modern works, or as we say nowadays, contemporary. There's a piece over there set on the green lawn like somebody's Tetris game thrown down on the ground. Is quite something. These are the Estas son las damas que no querían pasar en frente de la cámara, pero ya. I really need to stop running this camera and just sit here and enjoy this golden hour of afternoon. This is the bench where I sat on my first full day in Paris, 2 weeks ago tomorrow. In a certain way, I have come full circle back to this bench and back to myself. This is my middle week of my month in Paris. And I find myself beginning to miss my home. Old temptations call out to me. Even now, it is a struggle not to just walk to my apartment and sit down and work on the computer. But in 2 more weeks, I won't be here. I may never come here again. And even if I do, and even if I come here in the 2 weeks, I may never have such a splendid day as this blessed afternoon. By the clock, on the Musée d'Orsay, however it's pronounced, you can see that it is almost 6 o'clock. The sun is leaning down into the west, reaching for its rest. Chimneys on those buildings over there. That I just cannot leave. I will sit here and reflect upon the beauty. The beauty. The beauty.